is everyone doing during this weird time in the world that is called quarantine? And we're having to practice social distancing, and it's just so crazy, but it's giving us a lot more time to do other things. I remember a while back on my social media, I asked some people, like, what kind of videos do you want to see from me? And a few people had said, like, some type of makeup tutorial. And so I've never done really one of these, but we're gonna give it a try. I thought it'd be really fun to do Chibi Moon from Sailor Moon because she's just so adorable and so cute. And I can kind of cheat a little bit because I already have the pink hair. But I just have some of these like extra accessories, and literally I just got some materials from Walmart, super inexpensive, and I just got some like elastic material, cut it and glued it together so then it could go around my arms, and then I did the same thing so it looks like I have a little choker, and then I glued a little like pink diamond on there. So it is a Chibi Moon inspired look. So I know that they have moons up here on their necks, but I'm going to have like a pink round moon type diamond, especially because the pink super moon was the other night. Did y'all watch that? Yeah, so it's gonna kind of be based off of that, and a little based off of Chibi Moon, of course, and then just a little bit of little twists and turns that I want to throw in. So let's get started. Okay, so I already washed my face, and so the first thing I'm gonna do is put on a primer. I just use an e.l.f. primer because they're super affordable and inexpensive, and I think they work really well. So we're just gonna put a base on like that. And excuse my nails. Of course, y'all know like nothing's open right now. That is like one of my pet peeves about myself, is I have to have my nails done. Ugh, so it's driving me nuts. Next, I have a Real Techniques blender sponge, and I use Kat Von D medium 58 warm. I have not tanned in about a month due to the quarantine stuff, so it's probably gonna, yeah, it is not my color right now, but we'll just use some other stuff to try to lighten that up, especially because it's like anime. I wanted to kind of go for more of a lighter complected look. Wow, yeah, this is not my color right now. We'll fix this. Okay, now that we have foundation on, and it is obviously not my color right now, but hopefully we'll like try to fix this problem. So I'm gonna use my Tarte Shape Tape concealer. This one is Fair Neutral. I usually mix this one with a darker one, but I don't think we're gonna need to do that right now. Okay, when I think I got that all spread out, I'm going to take my Urban Decay Primer Potion. This is in color Eden. It's just a natural nude looking color, and I'm going to put these on my eyes. And I'm gonna kind of do this with my finger. Usually the body temperature is like from your hands helps it sit a little more into your skin. Get my Laura Mercier translucent powder, and this will definitely help with lightening up the color a little more and just kind of set everything in there. Okay, so now we got a nice smooth base. I'm going to be a little extra, and this is my little trick to really get some bright under eyes. So I'm going to use, first, it's the Becca Under Eye Brightening Corrector. So I just really want big eyes because it's anime, so really want to make things extra dramatic. So I'm going to put some of this down here also. And then go back in with the sponge and even that out. I'm gonna get the translucent powder and just set it above the eye corrector. Okay, so Chibi Moon has this crown that comes right across her forehead. So, to do that, I'm going to get a liquid liner and just kind of draw the crown on myself. This is gonna be real interesting. Okay, so that is a little lopsided. Let's try that again. That's the best I'm probably going to get right now, but it's okay because I'm going to draw inside the lines. So to do the lining of the mask, I just used a liquid liner. It would probably be a lot easier. I should have just made this myself. Oh man. So I got a NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in pure gold, and I'm just gonna start coloring inside. I'm going to go over the black lines too, just to kind of try to erase my mistakes. Okay, now we got our little crown on. I'm gonna go in and just try to clean some of the bottom up. So that gold was like the perfect color. So Chibi Moon has a little moon in the center. It's like a little half white moon, but because we're gonna be also influenced by the pink supermoon the other night, I'm going to get the little jewels that I used for the choker and you just get some eyelash adhesive and we're gonna use that as the moon in the center of the band. So I'm gonna put a little on the jewel and a little on my face. There we go. Okay, so I'm not touching that anymore because that was a lot harder than I thought. I'm not good at painting on my face, so we're leaving it at that. So now I'm gonna do my eyebrows. I'm just gonna do them how I normally do them right now, and then I'm going to try and make them pink. Also, for the first time, so y'all are seeing me attempt to do a lot of things for the first time. And I need my eyebrows done desperately, so we're just gonna work with what we have right now. But yes, I need to get them done. Okay, so the camera died while I was going through the pink eyebrows, but still working on them. But what I did is I just got a pink retractable liner and just kind of went in there and filled them in. Now, to make them look a little more natural, I'm going to get a pink eyeshadow and kind of dust them out a little bit. So I'm going to use the neon Huda Beauty and get one of the pink colors and just fill them in. So these eyebrows are super crazy, but we're just gonna work with them at the moment. Hopefully everything like will start blending together. So next we get to go to eyeshadows. So first on the brow line, I have the Pure Barbie eyeshadow palette. So I'm gonna use, it's very dirty right now, but this lighter color. Just really highlight that brow line. And then for all over the lid, I'm gonna use this really pretty lighter pink color. I'm gonna try to keep it as natural as possible because I really wanna try to make my eyes pop and nothing too dramatic because we already got the crown going on, the pink eyebrows, hair's gonna be another story. But this is just a really pretty soft pink. So this is exactly what I need. And then next to it, it's a little bit more of a rose gold metallic. So I'm gonna kind of get up into the creases with that. Yeah, I really like how that looks right now. So next we're gonna get our liquid liner again and I'm gonna, just gonna do a very subtle wing. I might need to do this in the mirror because doing this on the camera is really difficult. Okay, when I'm done, okay, so to add just a little bit more sparkle, I'm going to use the Urban Decay Heavy Metal Pink Glitter Liner, and I'm going to line right on top of the darker line I did. Now I'm going to get the jumbo eye pencil that I used for the band up here and go on my lower lash line. And to make my eyes open up a little more, I have a white liner from NYX. This is a liquid liner. Okay, now we have the white on the lower line. I probably should have used a pencil, noted for next time, but white eyeliner definitely makes your eyes pop, and that's exactly what we are trying to achieve with this anime look. From the same Pure Barbie palette, I'm going to get a darker brown color and just add a little bit of shadow underneath just to add more emphasis to the eye. Now I'm gonna put on mascara after I curl my lashes. Oh, and the mascara I'm using is NYX Worth the Hype. I'll switch in between different mascaras, but I really like the volume that comes out of this one. Okay, so now to move on to lashes, I'm going to use Ardell 3D Box Mink Lashes. This is number 854. I just like them because they're really multi-dimensional, so really trying to get those eyes to pop here. Okay, so now that we got the lashes on and our eyes are looking a lot bigger, I'm just gonna go do some light contour. So I use the Kat Von D contour palette in the powders, and I never use the lightest color, but this is the perfect time to use that. So going to take a contour brush and just do some light contour on my cheeks. Under my chin. I'm gonna stay away from my forehead right now. And then I'm going to get a slimmer contour brush and contour my nose. Then I'm going to get an angled brush and just kind of buff it out a little bit. So once we kind of have some light contour, now I'm gonna put on my blush. And this is from MAC, it's from the limited edition Patrick Star collection. I'm probably going to mix this. With a little bit of the Too Faced highlighter in Fancy Pink Diamond. Just to really get that glow. Okay, so my camera keeps dying because this is an old camera, so hopefully this is getting everything that I need on here. But I already went ahead and put the two little ponytails, so now I need to make them into buns. So all I'm gonna do to do that is I'm just gonna twist them up. And I just kind of be twisting and turning. Just kind of like that for now. I'll see if I want to fix them. Now we're gonna do the other side again, just twisting and turning. This one does not look as big as the other side. Okay, so we got the two little buns up here. Now we're gonna try to get these pigtails down. Make them highlight that and get them as close to the little buns as possible. Now that we got pigtails pretty close to the miniature buns, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take a strand of hair and wrap it around the hair tie so it blends even more together. And you can kind of hide the hair tie also. I'm gonna get a bobby pin. Again, get a strand of hair. And just wrap it around the hair tie. Now that we got those, I'm going to go in and just do some light curls just for me to have a little bit more volume. Okay, so I actually went in and fixed some stuff. I went and made like the little buns a little smaller just so I could have a little bit more hair to work with in the ponytails. So I'm using a bed head 1.5 inch barrel, and I'm just gonna do like just some loose curls. Nothing major. Just wanna add a little bit of volume, so gonna go through really quickly. Okay, I think that's it. There is my Chibi Moon makeup inspiration with a little twist. I'm feeling kind of an Egyptian look too, but I wanted the armbands because she wears gloves, so I don't have gloves right now. So I wanted it to kind of look like the top of the gloves, but just trying to also keep it consistent with like the gold and pink. But please let me know what you thought about it, or if there are any other looks that you'd want me to try out. And if you have any suggestions, please let me know, because definitely hadn't tried like the pink eyebrows before and just some of that stuff. But this is so fun to just play around with, and I hope y'all enjoyed it, and I'll see y'all next time.